Thank you very much, Pedro. What a pleasure it is. It's been a long 10 days that the Canadian delegation has been on the road. We were in Africa, we were in Germany for the G7, and here for NATO. But being able to finish with such a good friend with whom we are so aligned is exactly the right thing, because the leadership that you have shown over the years, the way we've been able to work together on all the things you've said, it has been not just constructive and productive for our peoples, it has not just been impactful on the world around us in our bilateral and multilateral work, but it's been a lot of fun to work with you, my friend, and I look forward to many, many more years of working very well together. I want to thank you formally to your government and to the people of Spain for hosting such a successful and important NATO summit this week. It's more important than ever that allies be aligned. We cannot let up on the momentum of our collective response to Putin's war of aggression. At the summit, we announced that Canada and its allies will augment the capacity of the NATO Enhanced Forward Presence Battle Group in Latvia, a mission, as you pointed out, where the two strongest countries in their presence are Canada and Spain, in which the working together that we do is actually a model for the eight other countries that are part of that battle group. In Latvia, we are actually redefining a concept that is so important to NATO, which is interoperability, making sure that all these friendly allied militaries who do things slightly differently with sometimes slightly different equipment can actually work together harmoniously is not just important to be able to do in times of conflict and difficult situations. It's actually an added advantage that we have if we do it right, and Spain has been extraordinarily important in that work that we're doing with the Latvians to develop a new way of operating, or a better way of operating for NATO that could be, unfortunately, if conflict requires it, extraordinarily useful in the future. On s'assure aussi que ce soit possible d'augmenter rapidement la taille et les capacités de ce groupe tactique pour qu'il soit prêt à assurer la défense sur le flanc est de l'OTAN. Aux membres des forces armées canadiennes et à tous les militaires de l'OTAN qui se tiennent à leur côté, y compris bien sûr les militaires espagnols, merci de nous aider à défendre chaque centimètre du territoire de l'OTAN. Putin's unjustifiable war is causing a steep rise in fuel prices and blockading critical fuel food exports that the world relies on, especially in the global south, and that's making food more expensive for people in our countries and leading to potential shortages for people in the most vulnerable parts of the world. And I have to again thank you, Pedro, for being alongside Canada, one of those strongest voices on the need for Europe and Western democracies in general to engage in real, substantive ways in not just humanitarian or development aid towards the Global South, but active partnerships around investment, around creating greater stability, greater economic opportunity, and greater wealth for people in the Global South, particularly given the multiple crises they're facing right now, whether it's economic crises, crises related to climate change, or the crisis of this war in Europe. These are things that are challenging everyone around the world. We see it in our own populations. How much more than the impact on vulnerable populations? And that's where your voice and others' voice in needing to step up on supporting people in vulnerable countries around the world is so important. We talked about actions we can take to support people and help economies grow in ways that provide good jobs and good incomes for everyone. One of the things we looked at is ways to deepen the strong trade ties between our two countries, which benefit workers and businesses in both Canada and in Spain. Depuis l'entrée en vigueur de l'accord économique et commercial global il y a 5 ans, le commerce entre nos pays a connu une croissance très rapide. Et on veut continuer sur cette lancée et renforcer les partenariats entre nos milieux des affaires, de l'investissement et de l'innovation. Le secteur des technologies propres et des énergies renouvelables présente un énorme potentiel de croissance. On a juste à regarder, par exemple, les efforts que nos pays déploient pour construire des réseaux électriques propres. Comme l'a montré l'invasion de l'Ukraine par la Russie, il est plus important que jamais que le monde accélère les progrès dans ce domaine. Spain and Canada both recognize that a strong climate plan is key to growing a strong, resilient economy and creating good jobs now and into the future. It's part of the responsibility we have to build a bright future in which younger generations can thrive, in which everyone can see themselves. We know it's a time of disruption, crisis, and change for people all around the world, and including in reasonably well-off and wealthy countries like Canada and Spain, there are a lot of people who look to the future and wonder if there's room for them in the future, if they're going to have a career, if they're going to have opportunities, if their kids are going to be able to grow up in the same communities they had. And the responsibility we have as progressive governments is to show that a future that is better on climate, that is more fair and equitable, will create more opportunities for everyone. Because fighting climate change is part of our work for a better future, alongside the values of protecting democracy, freedom, and equity that ensure opportunity for everyone. See, democracy is about everyone having a voice and everyone having the right to choose their own future. Donc l'Espagne et le Canada défendent les droits des femmes et des filles au pays et dans le monde entier. Aujourd'hui, on a réitéré notre engagement à favoriser l'égalité des sexes et le leadership des femmes dans le cadre de nos relations économiques. On s'engage aussi, comme l'a dit Pedro, à promouvoir une politique étrangère féministe sur la scène mondiale. Prime Minister Sanchez, Pedro, it was so great to sit down with you as my last stop on this trip. We are like-minded partners and friends, and I know that the work we do together will improve people's lives in Canada, in Spain, and beyond. Because by ensuring that we have strong, progressive voices standing up for equality, for democracy, and standing against authoritarianism and violations of international law is good for everyone. I'll be heading back to Canada this evening, and I'm energized by all the meetings I've had over the past days, from the Commonwealth heads of government to the G7, to this NATO summit, to this extraordinary bilateral visit, which was short but packed, as you've all seen, with a communique that touches on so many things, because we agree on so many things. Around the world, we're standing with Ukraine and holding Putin accountable for his unjustifiable and brutal war. We're working on strong economic recovery for everyone that creates new growth and opportunities. We're accelerating global action to fight climate change. We're enhancing our defense and deterrence posture, and we're reaffirming and strengthening the deep ties Canada has with countries and leaders around the world. And no better example than that than right here with you, my friend. Thank you very much for all your leadership. Thank you for your friendship. Muchas gracias.